Blood transfusions save 4.5 million lives every year. Yet around the world, a consistent shortage of blood costs many lives each year. Our bodies can accept only compatible blood types, and also type O negative blood, the universal donor type. Can science create type O negative blood from other more prevalent types, increasing the supply? There are four major blood groups, A, B, AB, and O. Blood types are determined by the presence or absence of certain sugar-based antigens, substances that can spark an immune response if they are foreign to the body. These antigens are labeled A and B. Type A blood has the A antigen, and type B blood has the B antigen. Type AB has both antigens. Type O, however, doesn't have either antigen. Another protein-based antigen, the Rh factor, can be either present with a plus or absent with a minus. This is important for blood transfusions, as Rh-negative blood will be rejected by a body with Rh-positive blood. These eight combinations are the most common blood types. Other variations, very rare blood types, comprise less than 1% of the population. Some antigens can trigger a patient's immune system to attack them, so safe blood transfusions depend on proper blood typing and cross-matching. When your body attacks these antigens, clumps of red blood cells and antibodies can form. If these clumps get too big, they can form blood clots, which can trigger severe symptoms and even lead to death. Type O negative blood cells lack these antigens and can be accepted by any blood type without being attacked. Therefore, this universal donor blood is very much in demand. This is particularly important in emergency rooms, where there may not be time to determine a patient's blood type. Type O blood can be made by removing the A or B antigens from other blood cell types, so the immune system doesn't recognize the blood as foreign. Scientists previously have had limited success with this because the enzymes used to strip red blood cells of the unwanted antigens aren't efficient enough to do so at an economically viable scale. Researchers at Canada's University of British Columbia have recently been searching the human gut microbiome for enzymes that can do this more efficiently. A and B antigens line the intestines, and some gut bacteria have evolved the ability to cut off these sugars in order to feed on them. After screening 20,000 fecal extracts, researchers identified a powerful new enzyme that can sever A antigens 30 times more efficiently than previous enzymes. This greatly reduces the cost of the process, as much less enzyme is needed to convert the blood. The enzyme successfully converted 100% of type A blood to type O in lab tests. Using this technique to convert type A blood could nearly double the availability of universal donor blood in the United States alone, as type A makes up just under one-third of the supply. Researchers still need to make sure the microbial enzymes don't alter anything else on the red blood cell, which could cause problems. If safety trials over the next few years go well, this technique could increase the amount of universal donor blood type available for patients who need it. While this research is ongoing, donating blood is still the best way to help. COVID-19 has further reduced supplies, but blood banks have safety protocols in place and remind us that it is safe to give blood during this time. Please visit the links below to learn more. Like, follow, subscribe, and catch us next time to see how you, plus science, can help save the world.